Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. This is another session on probability. You are watching Arvind Singh Academy channel, and we are now in the session of probability. This is another lecture, and hopefully you are doing well. You have watched all the previous lecture on probability before watching this lecture, and today we are going to discuss some more questions on fundamental principle of probability. So let me start today lecture. In this lecture, first I have to tell you about the playing card. Do you know what is the playing card? Are you aware about the playing card? If yes, then it's good. You are playing with the playing cards. What kind of how many games you know about the playing cards? Do you have some ideas? If no, many of you might be not knowing, so let me explain this. What are the playing card and what is the structure of playing card? So playing cards, how many playing cards are there? 52. Out of these 52 cards, there are two type of cards with colors, red and black, right? So half of them are red and half of them are black. No, is so? Further, these are called colors. Colors. Now, these are two type of cards. One is called diamond and another is called heart. And black are also of two type. One is called club and then spade. So 26 card divided into 13 and 13, and this 26 further divided into 13 and 13. So these are called suits. Four suits. One, how many suits? Four suits. What are those type of cards? Diamond is like this. You know, this is a diamond. Heart, everybody knows this. This is a heart. Club is something like this. And spade. Club is something like this and a spade is something like this, right? So these are the 13 type of cards. In each 13 card, their denominations are like this. Let me write. This is one card is called S. The second is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then there is one card called Jack. Another card is called Queen. And the final one is called King. Right? So these are 13 cards. Denomination of these 13 cards are like this. Out of these 13 cards, these are called face cards. Face cards. Why face cards? Because a specific face of persons are there, a face is there, and therefore this is called face card. A face look like my face, there is a card on it. So in each card there is a face, and therefore these are called face cards. And remaining 10 of them are called non-face cards. Non-face cards. Why non-face? Because there is no face, simple. There is no face, and that is why this is called non-face card. So, three face cards on each suit. So, there are four suits and therefore 12 cards. 10 non-face cards on each suit. So, in four suits, there will be 40 non-face cards. And 40 plus 12 again become 52. So, this is all about the distribution of cards. I hope you understand it and you got this. There are four suits, two colors. Four suits, right? And in each suit there are 13 cards, in which there are three face cards. One each face like this. I am not good in drawing, but I can make it. A jack is there, you know. A jack is there, something like this. Jack is there, you know. And here is a queen. Beautiful queen are there, and queen is there like this, you know. And there is a king like. Some turban is there, somehow turban is there, and that is a face like this. King is there. So a king is there, right? And here is a jack, and then a queen is there, some beautiful eyes, some good nose, you know. So some queen, king and jack, these are the three face cards. And apart from this face cards, you know, so face cards, there is somehow the mustache, and it is like this mouth and all. So these are the three type of cards called face cards. So in each suit there are three face cards. So in four suit there will be 12 face cards and 14 non-face cards. So how many queens are there? In each suit there is one queen. So in four suit there will be four queens. Similarly four kings. Similarly four jack. Similarly four ace. So each of the card are four in numbers. So whenever it is said numbers, then you will write it four. In each card are four in numbers. How many kings are there? Four. How many red kings are there? Two. Because red kings are only two. One and one, two. How many black kings are there? Two. How many red queens? Two, of course. How many total queens? Four. How many queens of heart? Then one, only one. How many spade of, how many spade cards? 13. How many jack of spade of jack? Jack of spade, sorry. Jack of spade, only one. So these are certain parameters, certain things which you know and you must keep in mind before solving the question, right? So let me write some question and how to answer all those questions. Let us see this and let me explain this all. So before doing the fundamental principle of probability, I would like to give you some questions on the basis of playing card only. So let us see this. Question is, from a well-shuffled pack of 50 cards, from well-shuffled pack of 52 cards, a card is drawn at random. Card is drawn at random. What is the probability that the card drawn is first question, a red card, second, a diamond, third card, a red queen, fourth question, an ace, fifth question, black jack, sixth question, a diamond or queen. So these are few questions that we have to analyze this. Now, what to do and how to do? You will try to understand, because out of 52 cards, if I draw a card, one card is drawn from a well-shuffled. Well-shuffled means they are mixed up well, a well-mixed up card. Well-shuffled means they are not arranged in particular way after getting this all playing cards, and they are going to reshuffle them, and after reshuffled, that is well-shuffled, one card is drawn. Which card will come? Will you tell me which card will come? Out of 52 cards, which card will come? Your answer will be, anyone may come. Because out of 52 cards, any one of them may come out. If I draw one card at random, means without pre-thinking, without any notions or preoccupied notions, without any planning, I draw one card at random from in the middle or somewhere else, out of the pack, what will happen? Which card will come? Any one out of 52 may come, because I draw one and only one card out of 52 cards. Therefore, out of 52 cards, if one card is drawn, there will be 52 possibility that may occurs. 52 different type of possibilities are occurs, and 52 different outcomes may happen. And the set of all outcomes are set, sample space. So there will be 52 items, 52 elements in sample space, and therefore without any hesitation I can write in sample space the number of elements would be how many. In sample space there will be 52 items. When a card is drawn from a well-shuffled pack of 52 cards, then 52 different type of events may occur, and therefore simple space may contain 52 different possibilities, 52 different outcomes, and therefore NS will be 52. Now for all question, because all question depend on after drawing a card is drawn, right, out of 52 cards. So simple space can have 52 different outcomes, and therefore NS is 52. Now what we need, our favorable outcomes. So for first question, what is favorable outcomes? Number of favorable outcomes. What if we want a red card out of 52 cards? How many cards are red? Of course half of them red and half of them are black, isn't it? So half of them are red, means there are 26 red cards. So 26 red cards are favorable for me. Any one out of those 26 card may come. If any one of those 26 card will come, you will be happy, because your favorite is getting a red card. So if any one out of those 26 red cards may come, you will be happy, because you want red card. Whatsoever, whosoever, which card may come, you don't mind. But you mind, if red card will come, you will be happy. It is your favorable one. So 26 red card are favorable for you, and therefore probability of an event is, as per definition, NF by NS, that is 26 by 52, and therefore answer is 1 by 2. For second part, if I write here, second part, A, what will happen? The total number of outcome or diamond is required. How many diamonds are there? 13 card of diamonds. So in that case, favorable items are 13. Each suit has 13 cards, 13 diamond, 13 spade, 13 club, 13 heart. So here 13 diamonds are favorable for you, and therefore probability in that case would be 13 by NF by NS. That is 13 by 52, which is 1 by 4, and that will be the answer of this question. For third question, if I would write here red queen, you know there are 4 queen. Out of those 4 queen, 2 of them are red and 2 of them are black. So 2 red queens, number of favorable items are 2 red queens, and therefore probability of event is 2 upon NF upon NS, that is 2 upon 52, and that is 1 upon 26. So this is 1 upon 26. For fourth question, what they ask? Fourth question, they ask an S. How many S? One S from each suit. Remember now? Each suit has one S. So one S from each suit, 4 S from 4 suit. So total number of S is 4, and therefore probability of that event is NF by NS. Again I am writing again and again just to recall you and memorize you. 1 by 13 is the answer of this question. Now for question number 5, what is that? Black jack. Again, the black is, how many jacks are there? 4 jacks. Out of them, 2 of them are black. So number of favorable in any one of those black jack will come, you will be happy. You love black jack, and 2 out out of those two, if anyone may come, then you will be happy out of favorable. So probability of that event is, what is probability of that event? NF by NS, and therefore this is 2 by 52, which is 1 by 26. Now, sixth question is, what is that? Diamond or queen? This is something different. Here the number of favorable outcomes are something different, and you want to know that. Here, what do you want? You want any card of diamond will come, then you will be happy. And if diamond will not come, then you will be happy if and only if queen will come. Means all 13 cards of diamond are favorable for you. You like all those 13 cards of diamond, and if diamond will not come, in that case, you also like 3 queens of other suit. So how many total cards are there? 13 cards of diamond is favorable, and 3 queens of other suits are favorable. So total 13 plus 3 is 16, and those 16 are favorable for you. So in that case, total favorable outcomes are 16, right? Favorable outcomes are 13 plus 3, 13 card of diamond and 3 queens of others. Some might be thinking that there are 4 queens. Why I am counting 3 queens? Because in 13 card of diamond, if I have taken, it means queen is already taken. Queen of diamond is already taken and included in those 13 cards. No need to take extra care of that queen. Nothing is special about it. So 13 card of diamond and 3 queens of other, that is 16 of them are favorable, and in that case probability of event would be 16 by 52, that is 4 by 13, and this will be the answer of this question. So I hope you got answer of all the questions nicely explained, and you understand all those questions by using this fact. So now I would like to tell you some more questions, some more idea about this, and one more question I would like to tell you on the basis of this, and let me run this. Again, the same question is given here. From well-shuffled pack of 52 cards, a card is drawn at random. Now the question is, this is the second question. Think of like this. This is the second question. And a card is drawn at random. What is the probability that it is a face card? A face card. Second, is a heart or queen. Third card, it is a queen or king. A king. A queen or a king. Fourth, a queen or face card. And fifth one, a jack or non-face card. Or non-face card, right? This is a few more questions. On the basis of that, I would like to deal with. Here again, NS is 52. It is not going to change for any kind of event. NS will remain fixed. It is not going to change. Now, here the first one is face card. So, face card, how many face cards are there? 12 face cards. So here favorable item is 12, and therefore probability of event would be NF by NS, that is 12 by 52, which will come what? 4 3 is 12 and 13 4 is 52, so 3 by 13 is answer. For second question, right? For second question, what is that? A heart or a queen? So heart or queen means all 13 card of heart is favorable, and three queens of other suit are favorable. So again it is a similar question. So here NF is 16 and probability of event is equal to NF by NS. So that will be 16 by 52, that is 4 by 13, right? Now the third question, a queen or a king, how many queens are there? 4 queens. How many kings are there? 4 kings. So 4 plus 4, 8. Here number of favorable items are 8 because 4 queen, 4 queen and 4 king. Right? So these are total 8. 8 items are favorable. If king will come, then you will be happy. If king will come, you will be happy. So 8 of them are favorable and therefore probability of that one is, probability of event is NF by NS and therefore 8 by 52 put is 2 by 13 and that will be answer. For fourth question, a queen or a face card? Queen is 4 and face cards are 12, but all queen are face cards, right now? So here queen cannot be counted separately because all queen are face cards. If any one of the 12 face cards, any one out of 12 face cards may come, you will be happy. Whether queen will come or face card will come, because it is, queen is not counted separately because it is included in face cards. So 12 face cards are here favorable only. You will not count queen separately and therefore probability of event is equal to, in that case, 12 upon 52, that is 3 upon 13. Fifth question, what is that? A jack or non-face card? Non-face cards are 40, jack are 4, so total favorable is 44. Here 44 of them are favorable out of 52 and therefore probability of event is NF by NS, that is 44 upon 52, that is 11 by 13, and this is the answer of this question. So in this way you understand the playing card, what is the possible questions out of the playing card may come, and you will be able to analyze those and you will be able to solve questions related to playing card. On the basis of that you will be able to write the answers. If there are, playing cards can have three different type of questions. Card is drawn at random. Card can be drawn one by one with replacement. And card can be drawn one by one without replacement. But that all are applicable when more than one item is drawn. In class 10th, you have not studied all those type of questions, right? When card is drawn one by one without replacement or with replacement, it is also not to a study for simple competitive, one day competitive examinations. So if you are looking for that event, then it is not a big issue. You can have questions related to this type only, where one and only one card can be drawn from a well-spread pack of 52 cards. So all questions of this type can be solved by using this. Thereafter, some more ideas about that. Let me write that formula and in next class we will discuss some questions on the basis of this. Till then, you must remember this. What is that? In set theory, this is a fundamental rule, and in set theory, you have studied about N A union B is equal to N A plus N B plus minus N A intersection B. Have you studied this? I hope so. You must have studied. Otherwise, you should watch the previous video lecture on set theory, what I have told you. And if I divide the whole thing by NS, what will describe this? This can be further described as probability of A union B. That is probability of A, that is probability of B, number of favorable item divided by total number of item, and this is probability of A intersection B. So this is a basic formula which you have to learn Now, on probability, that is probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Union means all you remember, or intersection means is AND. Union is considered for OR, intersection means in AND. When A and B happen together, then we will use this AND intersection. When either this or this will happen, then we will use symbol union, that is OR. So we will discuss this question on the basis of this in the next video lecture, and we will apply this. Till then, you must remember this formula. This is the basic concept, fundamental rule on probability, which you must study, must learn. And in next video lecture, we will discuss the questions related to it, and hopefully you will be able to understand it. So thank you very much for watching this. Keep watching our videos on YouTube, and if you have any problem, do write to us on our email ID, arvindsinghacademy@gmail.com. Or if you want to write some study material in writing or some questions for practice, do visit our website www.arvindsinghacademy.com. Right? So thank you very much for watching this. Have a great time ahead to you. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.